Welcome to Barbershop Stories episode.
What's happening?
On the podcast, yeah. I got my glass on, got my Blind Melon Jellies on.
Man. Cool, nigga.
That's right. Barbershop, damn, I can't get the words out, man.
Barbershop Stories. Episode 6, baby. We ain't here.
With dude they, from the barbershop in the building.
What they said. Well, we know
my
dude.
My partner, T. Stilly,
yo. We know dude from the barbershop. Yeah. We supposed to be introducing him. He just broke out and said, dude from the barbershop.
I got to get it in while I can, man. I don't want y'all to forget about me, man.
Eddie Kane.
Hey, we chilling though, man. You know, you're all fan. I don't know no better, man. You know, MK Wine was a hell ride. I'm gonna let my daughter fan
this,
know.
Don't start
but
this
we
shit.
In the shop on Thursday night.
Don't start this shit,
MK
man.
MK Wine was in here, man.
That right.
But I ain't have no help.
Hey, you.
They double teaming. Roll Tide. They double teaming, man. It's almost college football season. We can feel it, baby.
Man, have them Tide fans. Can't even spell Tuscaloosa.
Man, you know what time it is.
The dads having the Tide fan to spell Tuscaloosa, them they can be a fan no more.
They can spell R-T-R, baby. That's all they need to know how to spell.
Where that spell Rota?
Blowing shit in the game.
Hey, wait. I'm doing a podcast right now. Hey, what we had was back then.
Back then.
We ain't together no more.
Yeah,
I ain't been with you since Barack Obama was the president.
Yeah, he's so crazy, man.
Trump president now.
Oh, hey, he's a bad fella, yeah.
No, I ain't finna take no maternity test. It's paternity with a P.
That is tripping, man. I thought you said maternity. Tell that motherfucker you married, man.
I'm finna hang up. I'm finna hang up in 3 seconds. One, two.
Hey, by the way.
They find out you married, but hey, they be calling, man. They fight them out with a stick, man.
Look at you, man.
Hey, I'm married, man. I'm married, man.
Now, I'm going to give it to him. He a great guy, but he ain't did all that
we
talking on that Liberty and iPhone. He ain't did all that talking on that Liberty and iPhone.
Hey,
they
going
to get that straight right now. He might have been wishing somebody, but he ain't talked to nobody that long on that phone.
Man,
why you hate, man?
Hey, man. Look, hold up. My phone records.
You don't want to show your phone.
Yeah.
You don't want
to
show
that's
your
phone. That's what got us crisp clear to the world, man. Android, nigga. Note 3, baby.
Don't be mean spirited, man.
No, we fellow Woodlonians, man. We can't be mean spirited and you're Woodlonian. You know?
Hey, you got the Woodlawn bands. With long curtains in the building.
You know what I'm saying? Throw them dubs up. This is one of the official members of the W. Throw your W's up team.
Hey. All right. Yeah.
All right, he got it down pat.
Frank Five or throw your W's up. What's up, Peasy? We know you out there, baby. Hope you're watching,
what
man.
What up, GP?
Hey.
Yeah.
But hey, let everybody know what you got going on, man. For somebody be calling the house talking, hey, you watching Terry on this thing?
Hey, but hold on.
Everybody know what they got. With the singer that just dropped, and you know that what you got coming up with this tell that bitch I'm married.
Yeah, but see, but before you tell them about that bitch that you married,
okay,
we want them to tell them who you are, cause I'm sure there's some people watching.
Some heard of you, some didn't.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And some probably like, why the hell this nigga on here?
Okay.
But what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna let you take the second.
Okay.
Take the time, the opportunity
to tell
everybody, all the way from Cambodia to Saskatchewan,
everybody.
All the way back from Baltimore to Birmingham,
okay,
who the hell is dude from the barbershop and what brings you here? Who are you, man? Tell me.
Okay, my official introduction is I'm T. Steele, a.k.a. dude from the barbershop. A lot of y'all know me from way back in the day, from Rock House Records. I mean, we did our thing back in the day. Shout out to Sonny Black.
Rock out, rubber, baby.
And I gotta say this, being that we like worldwide with this, Sonny Black, he was the first person and only person to show me how to work Pro Tools for all my producers and musicians out there. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So as far as that, I gotta give props to him, Romeo, and you know, for just like I said, just showing me how to work the Pro Tools. I was already into music, and you know what I'm saying? The first piece of equipment I ever learned how to work for real, was a Control 24, you know what I'm saying? So that sound real big. We was doing that way. How long ago that been?
We're out of 90.
We were doing that back then, so you know what I'm saying? But like I said, I'm T Steel, aka Dude from the Barbershop.
Wally Jr.
And you know what I'm saying? I got my single out right now called Tell That Bitch I'm Married. It's out of the box. The clean version is Tell That Chick I'm Married, you know what I'm saying? But
I gotta get you, put some emphasis on bitch. Tell that bitch I'm married.
Yeah, got it. I mean it's outside the box. I think on Facebook I may have lost a couple of friends, you know what I'm saying? Folks ain't got a little sensitive about the title, you know what I'm saying?
Well,
but
a lot of people ain't looking at the art form of it though, because that's just like watching movies. You got movies like Terminator and shit like that.
Yeah.
But that don't mean Sylvester Stallone was a Terminator, but
exactly.
From what I know about you, you know, the brief introduction you gave, what I know about him, he do a lot of my production work. Like different songs I done dropped. Oh, ain't nothing. Oh,
see them. That's them bitches hating right there.
Damn,
tell that bitches hating right there.
God damn, tell that bitch I'm out of paint. But yeah, I know this fella. He produced a lot of the stuff I do, from the comedic side, doing sketches and doing what I call HSAs, hood service announcements, all the way to the song I got. It's called With Your Stankin' Ass. So we do a little cussing. It's called. That one is Tell That Bitch I'm Married. No, Tell That Bitch I'm Married.
Yeah, right.
And then you got With Your Stankin' Ass. You know what I'm saying? We put emphasis on it all. But it's just entertainment. So that's where I know I'm from. Producing, rapping. Then he's a fast rapper, too.
Yeah.
You know I know the nigga playing them drums at Woodlawn High School. That was making them beat guy from.
Woodlawn Colonel. That's
right.
That
drum line at Woodlawn High School, man. That's where I know that fella from, man. You know what I'm saying? Knew him a little bit before that, but officially met him at Woodlawn High School, beating still beating them drums on that computer, man. Hey, making that happen out here.
MPC. Hey, let me ask y'all something about the song. Like I said, it's called Tell That Bitch I'm Married. It's out everywhere, just in case anybody want to know. All streaming sites, you can buy it, stream it in, but 99 cents. Mm-hmm. And I wish we had like a female up here, but my thing is, it's called Tell That Bitch I'm Married, and some folks get offended, but I'm like, if you a female and your man he out and another chick try to holler at him and she know he married, she see the ring, would you rather him say, "Sorry, Miss Lady, I'm married, please leave me alone"? Or would you want him to say, "Bitch, I'm married, get the fuck away from me"? You know what I'm saying?
But see, now still, I agree with you with the dialogue about telling these bitches that you're married. But what you gotta understand is some of them chicks don't want no, as the young niggas say, they don't want no smoke because their ass ain't tiny. You been got small with somebody, got your old lady whooped. Tell the bitch I'm married, but tell that bitch give me some band-aids and gauze and shit too. So
that's why
sometimes you gotta watch the dialogue, man.
True that.
All women ain't tiny.
True that.
You gotta watch it, you know what I'm saying?
I feel that. But
let me ask you this though, how did you come up with that song? I mean, I know obviously you're married, you know what I'm saying, and all that. But was it any other songs out here that inspired you to make it, or were you trying to jump in a lane with other songs for a certain sound? Were you trying to blend in, or were you just trying to, or was that just on your heart to drop and you said, "Fuck all that shit, I'm just T Steel"?
Man, what's crazy is, and I got proof on my phone, I dropped this song in late 2016.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just sitting on it. And what I was doing, I was just at the house in my little home studio, just flipping through my songs that I had. And I just started playing it. And I was like, damn, what made me do that? And then I was like, it's so different. It's so outside the box. You know what I'm saying? I was like, you know what? I need to go on and put this out. And then as soon as I decided to put it out, probably about 3 weeks later, here go Black Men Don't Cheat from Lil Duval. So when he dropped his, I was like, I was on the song back then in 2016. I said, so let me go and put my little project out, you know what I'm saying, just to let people
that
know.
Way,
let them know it's another song out there. Now his, Lil Duval, shout out to him, because I like what he do with his, because he be on his grind. You know, his song is one way. My song is more like, it's more groovy, more jazzy. You know what I'm saying? And it's got a little ratchet to it. A lot of ratchet to it, as a matter of fact.
It's going to be a reception classic. 20 years from now, you can hear that shit at a reception. and go and switch that outfit on now. It's one of them. That motherfucker tight.
Hold on.
It's tight. It's tight. Oh, he got another phone call in the middle of the podcast. Stay tuned.
Hey, man, you going to make me run my meters out now. You keep on calling like this.
Try,
I don't care about you calling your brother. Which brother you talking about? Ain't nobody scared of your little brother.
Nigga, send my
tub guy. Hey, tell me. No, when they been out riding by their barbershop.
I do not want to talk to your mama. Bye. Bye.
From her. Who is that finding you, man? You got a real live stalker, though.
Who you think, man?
Capital One.
That been out.
Shit.
That's who that is.
Yeah. Well, let me ask you this, T-Steel. As far as on with the side of doing the production and the music.
Yeah.
You've been in it for a long time.
Yep.
What do you see Birmingham music now? How has it progressed or how has it degressed? And what do you see yourself fitting in the Birmingham scene? Falls with music. Because, you know, as you know, a lot of people that know music in the city, you know, you got some good speakers, but you got a lot of bad speakers because they say they don't support, they don't network, they don't want to get together. Do you find that to be true? No, it was a lot of questions at one time, but just go on.
I feel it. I can answer all of them.
Here
the thing. It's like the city definitely progressed from where we came from back in the day. Because you got artists out that's like out right now. They got millions of hits on YouTube that's signing to labels. You know what I'm saying? So the city has progressed. I think it's really the same damn near every city. It's just that for some reason, Birmingham just ain't got there yet. And then, like you were saying, you got artists that's progressing, and they may get to a certain level. They may get to that tier one status. And then you got other people in that ear like, hey, you got to leave. You know what I'm saying? You can't come back. You got to leave. Once you blow up, you got to leave. So they young artists, so they listening to that. So it's like they don't want to come back and help the people that's behind them, or they scared because they know that next dude behind them may be more fighting them. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So you got that. And
I don't understand why I like that, though, because it's like there's enough room for everybody.
It is.
As long as you're talented, you know, you're going to shine through on anything, no matter how many talented people on the track. You know what I'm saying?
It's like everybody trying to eat.
Everybody want to. I mean, ain't nothing wrong with competing, but if you want to compete to the point where it beef, that's just senseless, bro. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And especially if ain't no coins being made, I ain't going to say. Beef in the battle when they making money off of it. Cause that ain't worth shit either to me, you know. That ain't my, you know what I'm saying, forte. But if you doing it ain't making shit, man, chill out, man. Yeah. And take that music to the next level. Focus on that.
Well, see, I think a lot of them, you know, not in the defense of them, but I guess looking at it from another side, a lot of them, they ain't really got no example to go back.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You talking about a whole group of people, and all of them, they on a level where they ain't getting no money yet. Yeah, so it's easy to beat because there's a lot of frustration in there. It's like somebody just running in a circle and don't know where to go. Until it's somebody who come out of that group that they support and make it to the top, then they can kind of get an opportunity to see the other side. Yeah. So, but right now, you know, this beef because it look good to beef. Like when they see major artists beef, they making money. Like 57, he be picking with folks and shit. He can afford to do that. It's entertainment for him. It's a stream of revenue for him. But a lot of people here and all over the nation, like I said, it's the same thing. They don't see the other side that all this stuff is monetized. So until, you know, somebody get with them and kind of show them, like, take them up under their wing. Hell, if you got the time, because a lot of times, shit, you're still working on yourself. Yeah. But some people taking on the wing in each one teach one type situation is going to kind of be one and the same for years to come. Because like a lot of artists that make it, that don't come back, I'm going to go out on a limb and say this. I don't think they don't want to come back. I don't think they had the connection with a lot of them before they left. You know what I'm saying? So it's almost
that could
like,
be true.
I done got rich and you just want me to come look out. I don't know you.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
You threatened me online.
I've been doing it all along.
You know what I'm saying? So a lot of them, I think the gap just ain't been bridged. You know what I'm saying? Like people just ain't really just reached out and say, hey, bro, let's work. You know what I'm saying? And be serious. You know what I'm saying?
they ain't serious about it, one or the other.
Yeah, and yeah. then too, I think it got to be in you to want to pull up the next man. Mm-hmm. You know, like you got, like what I always tell Sam when we be talking about artists that got their own labels that's on that A1 level, Rick Ross, like it's obvious that he want the artists up under him to win. Yeah. And then you got other artists that they got their own label, but who do you see most? You see them, you don't see the people up under them. So what I'm saying is, like, when they come up from Birmingham or from wherever, it got to be in them to be like, hey, I'm finna help my crew. Or if they ain't got no crew, they ain't scared to politic with cats that they don't know that they feel talented and try to bring them up.
Right. They gonna be on there talking all that gangster shit. Then 9 times to get out of politics with somebody that look like the nigga who you talking about you is, and now y'all can't talk. Y'all stand across the club from each other, making up a reason to be mad at each other. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Man, get over there in politics if y'all serious about the business of music. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because it's a hard enough race to run as it is than to start out in some beef that's going to deter both of y'all from really working. And then, I know you got a lot more stuff going on. You got singles you put out.
One of my favorite singles I put out a couple of years ago called Fuck With You, FWU. Yeah. It's online. And I got a real good response from
Valentine's Day Mouse.
Yeah, I dropped it on Valentine's. And I was kind of scared to put it out because I had wrote the song. It wasn't really like on no rap. It was kind of more like R&B with a little rap feel to
it. Man, hold on. He riding that bitch trying to finesse it. I'm going to tell you. Man, I was sitting at T Steelhouse one day recording that stinking ass. And he gave me the opportunity to hear some of his works and shit. Man, that nigga shit so fire. That nigga just scared to put it out. See, that's the problem with Birmingham, too. We know we fire, but we be scared to put it out. But we got to realize sometimes you can be too fire. Well, that shit'll be sitting around 20 years. That's the nigga problem.
He definitely right.
When I heard that tell that bitch I'm married, I told him, hey man, let me help you with that shit. As a matter of fact, video shoot
this Sunday.
At the barbershop.
Appreciate you, man. Mac definitely put that battery pack in my back, man. Cause it's like when you're an artist, man, you hear a song, you be like, the first 2-3 times you hear, you be like, man, this the shit right here. This one finna take me up out of here. But you listen to that song about 300-400 times on 398 listens, you be like, okay, on to the next. It takes somebody new to come and be like Mac, he heard it, he was like, it's fire. And then when I put it out online, like across the US, because I got, you know what I'm saying, like my promotion thing going on, like over 50-some DJs downloaded the song. That's across the United States.
Tell that bitch I'm married.
How long that took? Soon. You say, because that happened pretty rapidly.
It probably took about maybe a week and a half for them to, you know, download. And for them to, because, you know, a lot of people listen to songs, but when somebody actually downloaded, that mean they really rocking with it. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
And for y'all that's out there spitting, man, it's a DJ game, man. You got to know the DJ. That mean you got to be out the house from in front of that computer sometime. Yeah. Making five music, one thing. And selling it on the internet, hey, it taking the league by storm. I can't, you know, the streets is one avenue. The internet is another. But the ones that make those two worlds meet, and those are some of your better artists that turn out, if you ask me. But you most definitely got to get out there and politic with those artists and those DJs, like Steel said. But I know some of the reasons you fall back sometimes because you also make tracks real heavy, too. And you've been making them, like I said, all the way from the days being a drummer.
Yep.
And tell them some things about the website you got.
I started my website last year. It's called 9to5 Music. That's my record label. It's 9DA5 Music. Again, that's number 9DA5Music.com. And that's where I sell all my tracks. And it's like a variety of tracks that I got on there. It's not just trap. It's not just tracks that sound like Tell That Bitch I'm Married. It's a variety. And you can get tracks for like $10.
That's right.
$10.
With your stinking ass.
Fresh. Yeah.
Now, my track, shit wasn't no motherfucking $10, though. Now, that's the introductory price. He gave me the gold package. You know what I mean? That's the gold package.
That's because he want the exclusive. He asked. He bought the beat. And just so artists that's out there that don't know, you can buy the exclusive, which that means the beat is yours. You got the Pro Tools file. You got the master file. But if you don't want to go that route, you can just lease the track. Some people lease tracks for $5. Some do it $10. Some do it $20 or $50. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I tell artists. Like, I had one artist come to me. He wanted to, he called me. He's like late at night. He was like, man, I want that track. I don't want nobody else to get that track. I'm about the exclusive. And, you know, I don't mind taking your money, but I got to sleep good at night. So this how I do. I told him, I said, look, man, I said, I don't mind taking your money. I said, but if I was you, because I'm an artist also. I said, if I was you, what I'd do is just pay $10 and just lease it. And you going to do what you going to do with it and see if it bubble up a little bit, if it do something. And if it start doing something, then come back and just buy the exclusive. That way you'll save yourself, you know what I'm saying, like $250. You know what I'm saying? You ain't just got to go out. These days, you ain't got to have a lot of money, you know what I'm saying, to get out there and put your music out there. Like I said, you can lease tracks for $5, $10. Lease the track, drop it, put it out, see what it do. If it start doing something for real, then you going by the exclusive. You'll save yourself a lot of money, homie, yeah. I'm telling you.
Unless you somebody like me that know they fired that promotion, and when I put that stinking ass out, it's going to be a hit. And I'm just going to give you a snippet of it. All right. What? Still, you can't be around me
with your stinking ass.
You too old for that shit
with your stinking ass.
Nigga, you must be sick
with your stinking ass.
With your stinking ass.
With your stinking ass.
I'm telling you, it's exclusive, man. You heard it right here.
Hey, when Max say he gonna do something, man, he come through. He come through every time, man.
Like mail.
For real. Never late. He gonna do it, man.
Oh, yeah. That TGIF payday was a hit I like, man, because you know what I'm saying? It was for the 9-5 guy.
Oh, yeah,
guy
yeah, that, yeah,
you know
yeah.
It wasn't your normal hit, but you know what I'm saying? It was in the wave of things, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That was happening when you dropped it a little while ago. But you always come left field on a nigga, because, you know, it might be trap over here, it might be conscious over there, it might be street, it might be dance or whatever you want to call it, yeah. Disco over there, and then you come right in the middle of it with a song for a nigga that working every day, you know what I'm saying, body business, take care of, you know what I'm saying,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying, man, that shit was fire ass song,
that,
man.
That's what it's about, though, man. It's like, I ain't gonna never put nothing out that's just in the wave of everything that's already going on right now. Yeah. Like, when I put TGIL Payday out, I was like, and like I said, it's TGIL Payday. It's on YouTube. You can buy that too. It's everywhere. Streaming sites and everything.
All right. Well, let me ask you this, Steel. You know, like I like to ask most artists. I know you, the butt naked truth with the ink pen.
Mm-hmm.
You the butt naked truth tuning them tunes. You freestyle?
I don't freestyle. I came to a realization, man, that shit just ain't my thing for real. Like, I play around
well,
with.
I tell you what, well, give us a little hot 16.
That nigga used to go.
Give us a hot 16. It can be something you got, some fresh off the dome, however you want to do
that
it.
Beat in on their ass, whatever you want to do.
Now, we can do it like this too. Now we
don't
can
go
take,
back now. You already know it.
We can take this bitch back to putting the middle school, 1992, beating on the tail. How hell you want to do it? Or you can just...
Or
you just
the oldest beat.
Hey, the oldest beat. Oh. You know what I'm saying? That's how you got this shit.
Press groove. Press groove, fat boom. Boy.
I don't be starting off like
boom,
this.
Boom, da, check. My name is Bennett. And he be trying to rap.
Okay.
His name is Bennett. What? He stay up in the trap.
What?
His name is Bennett.
What?
He got a barber shop.
What?
His name is Bennett. and get chilling in the pocket and like.
Wait on the wrist. I'm a motherfucking rapper.
Hey.
Niggas think I'm a motherfucking trapper.
Hey.
But I don't trap cause I'm scared of jail.
Hey.
Fuck that shit, nigga. Oh well. You can keep your time cause I could. Hell.
Drunk rap.
Same jokes. I don't care.
Drunk rap.
That's the it's shit drunk we do rap. When we're waiting on the song. Salmon no no. Fuck that shit is on. Dude from the barbershop doing his thing.
Yeah.
They need to hurry up and play the song, man.
But check it, if y'all want to hear me like flow, like I said, freestyling, that really ain't my thing. I write beats, write music, write songs. But check out IKR. It's called I Can't Rap. It's Can't, K-A-I-N-T. I Can't Rap by Dude from the Barbershop. Check that out online if you want to hear me spit. But like I said, man, I just came to the realization, like, that freestyling, that ain't my thing, man. But you want me to make a beat? You want me to write to that beat? You want me to drop that hit? I can do that.
Okay, hey. Well, before we log up out this thing, we finna let a sample play. You know what I'm saying? And if you can't really hear it, but it's like, damn, that shit fire, I can't hear it. Go ahead and download it from all your major streaming sites.
Please
iTunes,
stop
Spotify.
Calling me.
Title.
I'm married.
The whole nine.
Please stop calling me. I'm married.
Go ahead and play it, Sam. We finna play it. We finna play probably about 30 seconds to a minute of it, and then boom, we're gonna close out. Dude from the barbershop. Okay.
Yeah, I'm a savage on my exes. Since 21, I hit that yellow thing. Put a ring on it, yeah, I had to get a ring. Yeah, I'm on the grown man shit. Holla if you got a bad chick. I see them thighs with no panties. They want big bucks, all they did is whammies. OMG, she got a hairy neck. Razor bumps, all over her larynx. She want a ring, she ain't got them carrots yet. Bitch, you 40, you ain't married yet. Ooh, I think I heard some feelings. The dude is worth about a million. My crew, we trying to see a million. It's you, ain't even worth the drilling. Tell her bitch I'm married. Tell her bitch I'm married. She a bird, she a parrot. Tell her Mary Larry. She came in third cause she average. Very scary. Tell her bitch I'm married.
Okay.
Tell her bitch I'm married.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah,
like you said, tell that bitch I'm married. Available on all streaming sites. That's your title. That's your Amazon. You can even go to the YouTube. You can go there if you don't want to buy it. You just want to do it. You like the streams too. So, but 99 cent ain't bad. You know what I'm saying?
99 cent.
You gotta help move this project. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Birmingham, the South, the United States, and the world. Tell that bitch I'm married. I'm sure that there's gonna be a win, what they call
out.
A reception,
banger.
Hit, banger, for the next 20 years.
I can see a line dance in that bitch now, all
day. Hey, follow me on all social media. Follow me on all social media at Dude From The Barbershop. That's at Dude From DA Barbershop. That's all social media. Check out my beats at www.9da5music.com. And, hey, just follow me, man. I appreciate everybody's support.
Oh, yeah.
That nigga in what line?
Oh, yeah. And before we close out, we'd like to say, first off, appreciate Dude From The Barbershop, T-Steel, for taking the time to come on out here, because the nigga got two donuts and two big time. So that take a lot. It take a lot, you know what I'm saying, to even do that. So we appreciate him coming out.
Why you so mean-spirited, man?
I just want to tell the truth that you ain't the only one going through this shit still. You need to tell the world, because somebody else going through this, and they was embarrassed to mention, but since they know that Dude From The Barbershop hasn't changed his tie since January, they ain't no shame no more.
They crazy.
You know what I'm saying? Some real shit. Thank you, man. Thank you.
I ain't coming up here. Thank you, man. You be on
crackers, man.
Nah, I'm fucking with you. But yeah, man. Hey, make sure you check him out on all social media. Then also too, you can also check out Barbershop episode 1 through 5 and 6.
Yep.
On YouTube. Go to youtube.com/ MacMan Entertainment. MacMan Entertainment. Or you can just go to comedyandbham.com.
Yep.
comedyandbham.com. You can see all the different shows, all the different events, all the different spots, and everything that's going on. Like I said, you can see the haircuts on here. We open 7 days a week. Let me see who else. I'm gonna give a couple shout outs because, you know, can't end without shouting out folks that I've been working with for a while and I just simply want to see make it. Shout out to Big Gloss Barbecue.
Yep.
Big Gloss Barbecue is one of the best in the business, man. I ain't never seen a nigga flip meat with a nigga hand.
Lick
his finger, flip them holes, and it don't even burn. I'm telling you, pick shit up, the shit fall out the bone.
He washed his hands first, though. He washed his hands
every now and then. Every now and then, because he told me the heat will kill it. He said the heat will kill the germ, and I believe him. But the shit is good, though. Big Gloss Barbecue. Also, New Sound Music, man. The man do beats, T-shirts. He'll talk to you. You know, he charges $10 an hour to just talk to you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Fred Bingo. Hey, the whole nine, New Sound Music. Check him out. Also, two V949. That's my other job, one of my other jobs, V949 Home Team Morning Show. Shout out to Homie Jay. Shout out to comedian Ms. V. What's up, Cat Studios?
Yeah,
shout out to her. Shout out to Chris Colvin. Shout out to Tracy, Run, Terrence, T. Carson, the whole nine, man. Shout out to you. Who else? Shout out to Ben and Hurst, too, with Bond Productions, man. Yeah. What's
happening? Everybody out there running.
What's happening? Steve, what's going on? What's going on?
Hey, in prison and free, man. Y'all keep pushing it. This Birmingham rap scene gonna jump off, man. Hey, it's an underground bubble like none ever. It can't succeed. It just got to all meet up. We need to start grinding with each other. You know what I'm saying? It ain't. Don't make dollars, it don't make sense. So, you know, I understand if cats don't meet up because it's not making sense, because they don't make dollars. So we need to get on another level with it if that ain't where we at, you know what I'm saying? Because that's what time it is in the hand, man. But and partner still, he got avenues with streams of revenue coming that's helping him sustain himself within the music business. You have to place yourself in a, you know what I'm saying? In a position keep doing it, you know what I'm saying? Because you have to. If not, you know what? The burnout is real.
Yeah,
we got partners out there, man, that's still in the game. Peasy, like I said, we throw your W's up. Snake said, turn that thing to the side because it's east side, but we throwing them W's up either way it go. Cause hey, we rocking with the whole ham, the whole
that's
state,
right.
The whole nation, baby. Yeah. That's how we doing it. Dude that's from the barbershop came through, representing with us, man. I'm no. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and I'm comedian narrator, haircut slanger, Benny Mac, and I just got probably about one more minute worth of announcements. On the 24th of this month, August 24th, if you are in the Leeds area, man, come check me out. Me, comedian Charles Winston, comedian Lavelle, comedian Mr. Canaday, comedian Charity. I appreciate y'all bringing me out on the 24th in Leeds, Alabama. Let me see what else. On the 31st, Make Music. That's with Cut Dog, Digger, A-Rock, a.k.a. Tonio. Y'all make sure y'all come check that out on the 31st. And the 1st, check me out at the I Push Foodie Music Festival. Festival over in Inslee. Historic Inslee, man, right in the downtown area.
This
shout out to Rico with I Push Magazine. Then two. October the 12th, man, I'm up in Chattanooga. I'm on a boat. You know what I'm saying? I'm on a boat doing some comedy. You know, it's on the river doing some comedy on the river. You know,
what's up?
That's going to be tight. Then also September the 3rd, make sure you check out Tuesday Night Laughs. That's up at Roots Place. I got a Tuesday night. We're doing a Tuesday night up at Roots Place. She the truth too. So just come check it out, man. And then also Live at the Barbershop starts back up in September. That's September the 21st. So make sure you stay tuned to that. Then also I got merchandise, t-shirts, DVDs. You can go online to download the comedy album, Mo Forehead in the Face. Also on the 14th of September, I'm doing a movie premiere for a guy, Sherlock. He got me doing some comedy in his movie. So I'm like, hey, that's what's up. That's going to be at the Inslee Soho, September the 14th. September the 15th, I'm at the Boss Lounge, me, Sir Walt, JP, with Ripcord for the J.O. reunion. Like how Woodlawn did that thing. J.O., they invited me out. Doing a little comedy.
Yeah, we gonna see what they gonna do. Yeah, we gonna see what they gonna do.
So y'all ain't green, I mean.
Yeah, so shout out to everybody. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I appreciate the boogers on making every last one of them hoes. I'm the hardest working nigga that
he
I know.
He is.
I know there's a bunch of folks out there working hard, but God damn it, right now I'm talking about me. So, hey, I just want to see it work, and I sleep when I'm tired. But right now, I'm woke. So, hey, and shout out to K1. Shout out to Allison with Dead Wrong. K1. The next stop, Nick City, coming soon. Yep. If you haven't seen that play, goddamn it, y'all missing out, man. So just make sure you stay tuned in. ComedyandBham.com. Or go to my Instagram at BennyMac205. That's BennyMac205. Sam, what's your Instagram?
Sammy No Nose. That's, I was finna say email address.
He got to spell
it for
him.
I'm not getting in that Instagram world.
Now you got to keep mind.
I'm catching up speed. I've been on the book, but hey.
That nigga fine as fuck.
You know what?
But that nigga motherfucker got a flip phone. Flip phone with that motherfucking IG, so you got to spell
N-O-N-O-S.
That is.
No, man.
They can't pick it up on that no
kill. No, no, no.
Yeah, I'm talking for real. He
wanted to hold him on the ground, though, man. I'm up on that, man. You know what? Sharing the information. Get on YouTube and
check it out. He one of them niggas that holler in the phone when he talk to you and he can't hear. He be like, hello? Hello? Okay, God damn it, hello?
They want to break out cracking, huh?
Hey, and I just want to say this.
I'm back home with them all my glasses on, this whole Mac tonight. Max.
Hey, even blind Melagella, man.
Hey, all the fellas out there. Hey, if you done cheated on your girl, you done cheated on your wife, don't worry. I got a solution. Just go and download, buy, or whatever you want to do, stream, tell that bitch I'm married. Just pull up in front of her house, turn that bitch up real loud, she gonna take you back. Like I said, you cheated. It's all good. Just go on by, tell that bitch I'm married. Let your old lady hit. She'll let you back in the house.
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? It's hot outside.
Yeah, pull her back up in the house. In the house. Play it as loud as you can.
As loud as you
can. Make sure she is.
Nah, that shit don't work. Hey.
Play it till the light come on.
Be more careful.
Man, where do you women here? They'll question you about that shit. So why the fuck you want to play the song now? What the fuck you been doing? They'll snap on your ass about that
crazy
shit. They'll snap about that shit.
Man, you don't want to be saying, tell that bitch I'm divorced.
Yeah, it don't cost you.
It's gonna cost.
That shit take money.
Hey, well that's what it is. Like Sam said, the wild word. What did it say, Sam? It take money.
It take money.
Barbershop, episode 6. Dude from the barbershop, and we out. Yeah.